Today, I want to welcome everyone, and this is Melody from Melodies from Heaven Entertainment Corporation presenting to you the Gospel Concert of the Year in honor of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. The event will be held on January 18, 2013 at 8 o'clock p.m. Melodies from Heaven presents to you Kirk Franklin, Leandria Johnson, and Vashon Mitchell. Kirk Franklin, 9-time Grammy Award winner, an American Music Award winner, 39 Stellar Awards, 16 Dove Awards, 8 NAACP Image Awards, 2 BET Music Awards, a Soul Train Award, and numerous others will be presented in honor of Dr. Martin Luther King. Along with him, we have Leandria Johnson, the Grammy Award-winning American gospel musician and singer-songwriter from Orlando, Florida, who won Kirk Franklin's Sunday Best Gospel Talent Competition. She entered the Billboard Gospel chart at number 1. And her album and CD, The Awakening of Leandria Johnson, was released in 2011. And she won a Grammy in 2012 for the Best Gospel Contemporary Christian Music Performance. And last but least, Vashon Mitchell, whose music you hear in the background, is a 6-time Stellar Award winner and Grammy nominated recording artist. His song, Nobody Greater Than You, was nominated the number 1 most played gospel record. And his album, Triumphant, the number 1 gospel album of 2011. He has 2 Grammys and 2 GMA Dove Awards. Now, I chose Clients to do this concert. This would be a great place to have a gospel concert in celebration of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. birthday. Because on November 10, 1967, Dr. Martin Luther King visited Clients, and in a speech entitled The Future of Integration, before about 2,500 persons, sponsored by the Graduate Student Association of the University of Buffalo, my alma mater, he proclaimed, "We are moving toward the day when we will judge a man by his character and ability instead of by the color of his skin." So we felt that this would be a fitting place for this concert. And not only is it a fitting place, but Clive has been known to be one of the most acoustically sound music venue in the world. The architecture is just brilliant. Show schedule. At 7 a.m., Kirk, Vashon, and Leandra will arise and get dressed. At 8 o'clock, they will all eat a European breakfast at the Mansion on the Delaware. At 9, their house car will arrive to take Kirk, Leandra, and Vashon to WKBW TV studio on Delaware to be interviewed by the host, Linda Pellegrino, for AM Buffalo at 10 a.m. At 11, they will visit Zion Dominion Church to attend a special service where the pastor, Robert Innes, will officiate. At 1 o'clock p.m., the gospel artists will return to the hotel to eat lunch. From 2 to 4, they are free to tour the sites in the city and in Niagara Falls. At 4 p.m., they will go to the gospel radio station WUFO in Buffalo, New York. They will talk live on the air with DJ Anita Williams to promote their albums, the concert, and to connect with their fan base. At 4:30, they will arrive back at the mansion on the Delaware to eat dinner and rest before the 6 o'clock sound check at Client Hands. At 6, they will arrive backstage at Client Hands for a sound check, makeup, and last-minute preparations. At 8 p.m., the concert will start, and it concludes at 11 p.m. Artists attend an after-party at Henry's and Client Hands. Afterwards, they'll spend the night at the mansion. And in the morning, they will be taken in a limo to Buffalo Niagara Airport. The rider will consist of two full-size cargo vans to transfer the band equipment for the artist and a van for the choir and band members. Plane tickets will be given first class for Fashan and Kurt and Leandria, level 2, and from the airport, anywhere else they will go while they're in town. The dressing rooms will be available approximately at 6 p.m. And Kirk Franklin's dressing room will accommodate 4 people with restroom and shower facilities. Leandrea and Vashon will have dressing rooms with restrooms nearby. In each dressing room, there will be fresh coffee, water, ginger ale, and fixings for sandwiches. The choir and the band dressing rooms will accommodate 24 people. They will have fresh coffee, water, orange juice, and make it for sandwiches also. The budget for this event is the talent will cost $120,000. The marketing cost is $5,000. The catering cost is $500. The support staff $1,000. Revenue cost $5,000. Event insurance $5,000. For a total expense of $261,500. The income will include general admission at $40. Estimated sales of $2,000 for a total of $80,000. The VIP admission $65, which gets you a backstage pass to Henry's restaurant at the end of the concert. Estimated sales $500 for a total of $32,500. And DVD sales at $10 each. Estimated sales at $40,000 for a total of $400,000. The cost of goods is $125,000 and the gross margin $387,500 with a net profit of $126,000. As with any event, there's risks that are involved. There could be bad weather and the plane gets delayed from entering the airport. The artists are not able to make it to the AM Buffalo at 10 a.m. This is low risk, but the plan is to have the artists make up the time on the tour and head down to the record theater on Main Street to sign autographs and do a meet and greet with fans for an hour. Second risk could be the van carrying the musical instruments and the gospel choir and band. does not arrive on time. This is high risk. To mitigate against this is a contingency plan to pay clients for the use of their band equipment and to use the gospel choir at Zion Dominion Global Ministries as a backup. And then third, one of the artists may have a family emergency. This is a high risk because fans will be disappointed. To mitigate against this, we have to stand in local talent to be ready if necessary. We have a Gospel Sunday's Best contestant lives right here in Buffalo that will perform if necessary. What I learned that artist management involves being able to pull together a lot of details. It requires you to be able to communicate with diverse people and command cooperation and respect. You have to be a detailed person, accurate, and follow through on everything from start to finish. You have to know a lot about budgeting and making sure the event is successful by reaping a profit. I also realized that being an artist manager is about being a leader and a visionary. It's about packaging your product so that you will make a lasting impression on your fans and your brand. If done correctly, you will set yourself apart from the competition.